In the previous video, you saw how you could easily import footage into the Media Hub. Now let's have a look at dealing with files containing embedded alpha channels, and then we'll examine how to handle Photoshop files in the Media Hub. Using the file browser, I have browsed to a folder that contains a graphic file with an embedded alpha and a Photoshop PSD file. You can see at the bottom right-hand corner of both clips, they each have a multi-tag. This is your indication that there is more data embedded in the file. If you double-click on the multi-tag, the file browser will expand the clip and expose the different channels. Here you can see the RGB channel and the alpha channel. Typically, when Smoke imports media with multiple channels, it will create a separate clip per channel. You can import the channels as separate clips, but most of the time, you probably don't need to. Double-click on the multi-tag again to collapse the clip. In the general menu under Clip Options, there is a pull-down menu for dealing with alpha channels. The first option is Include Alpha Media. This will split apart your alpha channel from your fill, and you land up with two clips. You can also choose to ignore the alpha channel completely, and this will only create one clip with no alpha. Or you can choose to create a matte container, which emulates a clip with an embedded alpha in Smoke. This means you will always have the correct information for keying and compositing from the specific source. Now, a Photoshop file is slightly different from your typical multi-channel file with alpha. The PSD file also contains layering content, positioning information, and blending information. Bearing that in mind, you have two choices. If you just want to have access to the Photoshop layers and exclude the positioning data, then you would import through the Media Hub. If you want to import the Photoshop file for compositing purposes, then you must import it directly into the Action 3D compositor, which understands position and blending information. This will be covered in a later video. Considering the first choice for now, the Photoshop file is also represented with a multi-tag on the clip, and you can expose every layer from the file. So if someone has given you a Photoshop file with variations of graphics, it is an easy way to pull out just what you need. Or you can pull out every layer. The only item to be aware of is resolution. Each layer could be a different resolution to the canvas it was created on. Switch to the Format Specific options and select Layer Options from the pop-up menu. Here you can choose whether each layer is scaled up to the background resolution or whether each layer should keep its native resolution. To import the Photoshop file, select and right-click on the library to create a new folder. I will just call my folder PSD. Next, I'll drag the Photoshop file into the PSD folder. When I expand the folder, I will get a flattened clip of the composite as well as all the layers as separate clips. The alpha channel settings we set up earlier will affect how the alpha channel from each layer is interpreted. So depending on the settings, the alpha could be separate, ignored, or included in the matte container with each layer. As I said, for proper compositing purposes, in a later video, we will look at importing a Photoshop file directly into the Action 3D compositor in order to retain the original composition. For those of you who wish to bring in timelines from Final Cut Pro 7, Final Cut Pro 10, or Avid Media Composer, please watch the next video on conforming basics. If you just want to start organizing your media for your edit in Smoke, please proceed to the video on organizing your media and sequences.